Hello everybody, and a very warm welcome to LMT YouTube channel.
Losing someone close to you is never easy, no matter how old you are. When they pass away suddenly, with no warning whatsoever, it is even more difficult to process the loss. When Princess Diana was killed in a 1997 Paris car crash, people all over the world were saddened by what had happened, and the effects of her death are still felt to this very day. For her two sons, Prince William and Prince Harry, it was more difficult than anyone ever could have imagined. Not only were the two boys, who were at the time ages 15 and 12 respectively, dealing with the unexpected loss of a parent, but they were doing it in front of the entire world. Billions of people were watching as the two princes walked behind their beloved mother's casket, both with heartbroken looks on their faces. Although more than 20 years have passed, there is no doubt that Diana is still greatly missed. In fact, a language expert says that Prince Harry is still mourning his mother like a young boy. Prince Harry is sixth in line to the British throne. Prince Harry is one of the most famous people in the entire world and has been since the day he was born. Also known as the Duke of Sussex, Prince Harry is currently married to former American actress Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, and the couple has a young son, Archie Harrison. Although Prince Harry still remains sixth in line to the British throne, behind his father, brother, nephews, and niece, he and Meghan stepped down from royal duties in a move called Megxit and relocated to a new home in Montecito, California. They were very excited to embark on their new journey, and they have been keeping pretty busy since the move. The couple took on a progressive new role by becoming financially independent and raising their son away from the royal spotlight. They have been working with charitable causes and recently launched their first podcast titled Archwell Audio. The tragic death of Princess Diana. Prince Harry was the youngest son of Princess Diana, and judging from the pictures of him as a young child, he adored her more than words can say. This really doesn't come as much of a surprise, since Princess Diana was quite open about prioritizing her roles as a mother first and a princess second. She doted on Prince Harry and Prince William right up until her death in 1997, when she was involved in a fatal car accident in Paris. The driver of the car that Princess Diana and several others were traveling in was being chased by photographers, ultimately crashing into a pillar in the Pont de l'Alma tunnel, resulting in the death of the princess, her boyfriend Dodi Fayed, and their driver, Henry Paul. The next few days were filled with shock and sadness, and Queen Elizabeth summed it up perfectly by saying that Diana was an exceptional and gifted human being. Prince Harry is still mourning his mother like a young boy. Prince Harry definitely has a busy life, but that doesn't mean that he has forgotten about his love for his mother. A language expert reports that he is still mourning her, and it shows. What led to this conclusion? Well, it had to do with the launch of the couple's Archwell website, where the mission statement speaks volumes. The message, titled A Letter for 2021, starts off by saying, "I am my mother's son," and talks about kindness and compassion to things that Diana was known for. The language expert Judy James says how the message seems to show how Prince Harry still feels the pain of his mother's death, even after all these years, and how he misses her so deeply. Says James, there is the suggestion that Harry is the heir of Diana's passion for compassion. She goes on to say that it also sounds like a bid to inherit her popularity and the love people around the world had for her. Seems like Harry has the same love in his heart for his mother as always, and that will continue forever.
Another analysis.
The most difficult days of Meghan Markle's life. Despite how much fun it seems to marry a prince, it definitely hasn't been easy being Meghan Markle, especially over the past few years. Though she definitely had her ups and downs before she met Prince Harry and got a taste of royal life, it seems things have become even more challenging for her, as she began to live her life under much more of a microscope than she did when she was simply known as one of the stars of Suits. Between the family drama that practically overshadowed her massive royal wedding to Harry in 2018, the relationship issues Meghan faced before she and Harry were even a thing, and the criticism she's been constantly receiving since joining the firm, there's no doubt that Meghan has struggled. Sure, she has a gorgeous husband, a killer royal wardrobe, and major deals with Netflix and Spotify that could really elevate her career in the near future, but those wonderful parts of her life didn't come without plenty of challenges as well. These are some of the most difficult times that Meghan has faced in her life so far, at least, the ones that have been public enough for us to find out about. Now that she and Prince Harry are happily settled in California with their son, Archie, and a lot more privacy, it finally seems like things might be looking up for the Duchess of Sussex. Family drama plagued Meghan Markle's royal wedding prep. The days leading up to the royal wedding in 2018 were pretty dramatic, to say the least, thanks to Meghan Markle's family across the pond. For starters, her half-sister, Samantha Grant, called her out on Twitter and since deleted tweets for not inviting her and the rest of her family on Dad Thomas Markle's side to the wedding. That was just 1 month before Meghan and Prince Harry were due to walk down the aisle, and things only devolved from there. Though Meghan's dad, Thomas, was invited, he ultimately ended up not making the trip to the UK. In early May, he suddenly began surfacing in many paparazzi photos, which he later admitted had been staged. After speaking with Thomas, TMZ reported that a paparazzi agency approached him, willing to pay money for photos, and he agreed, hoping he could cast himself in a more positive light ahead of his daughter's wedding. But in the end, that didn't actually matter. Thomas had a heart attack and needed surgery, rendering him unable to travel and to walk his daughter down the aisle. Meghan then released a statement about her father via Kensington Palace, stating, "This is a deeply personal moment for Ms. Meghan in the days before her wedding. She and Prince Harry ask again for understanding and respect to be extended to Mr. Markle in this difficult situation." Meghan Markle's letter to her dad went public. In February 2019, Meghan Markle had written to Dad Thomas Markle after he had spoken to the press about their estranged relationship, making their private struggles very public. In the handwritten letter, Meghan told her father that his actions have broken her heart into a million pieces and that he had caused her unwarranted pain. She also accused him of lying when he said he'd called her to let her know he wouldn't be able to make her wedding. Meghan adding, "If you love me as you tell the press you do, please stop. Please allow us to live our lives in peace. Please stop lying. Please stop creating so much pain. Please stop exploiting my relationship with my husband." Since then, Meghan has filed a lawsuit against the Daily Mail for publishing the letter. In October 2019, Prince Harry defended her decision to sue in a statement on their official website, which read, in part, he said, "The contents of a private letter were published unlawfully, in an intentionally destructive manner to manipulate you, the reader, and further the divisive agenda of the media group in question. In addition to their unlawful publication of this private document, they purposely misled you by strategically omitting select paragraphs, specific sentences, and even singular words to mask the lies they had perpetuated for over a year." The new mom's struggle was very real for Meghan Markle. Meghan Markle made headlines in October 2019 when she and Prince Harry, along with their son, Archie, who was 5 months old, at the time were being interviewed for their ITV documentary, Harry and Meghan, An African Journey. Talking to journalist Tom Bradby, Meghan broke her notorious silence with the press and got candid about the very real struggles of attempting to balance her real-life struggles under such intense public scrutiny. Meghan said, "Any woman, especially when they're pregnant, you're really vulnerable. So that was made really challenging. And then when you have a newborn, especially as a woman, it's a lot. So you add this on top of just trying to be a new mom or trying to be a newlywed." At the same time, Meghan also admitted that Bradby had been the first to ask her how she was doing as a new mom and agreeing that she was not really okay. The Megxit announcement. In January 2020, following a long sabbatical, in Canada over the holidays, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry made an announcement that would shock most royal fans. Releasing a statement on Instagram, they shared that they would be stepping down from their positions as senior members of the royal family in favor of a bit more independence and privacy. Their statement said, "We now plan to balance our time between the United Kingdom and North America, continuing to honor our duty to the Queen, the Commonwealth, and our patronages." They went on to explain that they wanted to raise their firstborn son Archie with an appreciation for the royal tradition into which he was born, while having more of an ability to take the direction they chose in the next steps of their careers. Following their announcement, there was much debate about how the royal family might feel on the subject. Queen Elizabeth's statement on the matter, released 10 days after the so-called Megxit announcement, claimed that all parties found a constructive and supportive way forward. This included Harry and Meghan no longer receiving public funds for royal duties, as well as relinquishing their HRH titles. Although the Queen did express her pride over how Meghan has so quickly become one of the family, both Harry and Meghan continued to get backlash for months, even after they'd finished up their royal engagements and moved to the United States for good. Were Meghan and Harry publicly snubbed by William and Kate? In March 2020, Prince Harry and Meghan Markle finished up their final official royal engagement when returning to the United Kingdom for Commonwealth Day, at which point they reunited with Prince William and Kate Middleton and the rest of the royals for the first time. Unfortunately, this didn't exactly result in the warm send-off they might have been hoping for, and instead ended up drumming up even more feud rumors than what was already going around, particularly where Harry and William's fractured relationship was concerned. In photos and videos that emerged from Commonwealth Day, it seemed like William and Kate totally snubbed Meghan and Harry at the service they all attended, and the whole scene seemed pretty awkward altogether. The Sussexes never publicly spoke out about the situation, but royal historian Robert Lacey wrote, in his book, Battle of Brothers, that it was actually an emotional time for the couple, with Harry fighting back tears during the event. Meghan Markle's miscarriage was devastating. In November 2020, Meghan Markle published an emotional essay for the New York Times, where she revealed for the first time that she had suffered a miscarriage earlier in the year while she was secretly pregnant with her second child. She wrote that she felt a sharp cramp while tending to Archie in his nursery and knew exactly what was happening in that moment. The experience had led her to discover just how common miscarriages were, and encouraged her readers to ask others in their lives if they're okay, as everyone collectively coped with the difficult year that many had faced in 2020. Meghan Markle's first marriage ended in divorce. One of the reasons Meghan Markle was such a surprising pick for Prince Harry to settle down with, the fact that her marriage to him wouldn't be her first. In August 2013, Meghan's two-year marriage to film producer Trevor Engelson came to an end, when they quietly separated, later finalizing their no-fault divorce in a similarly low-key way. Meghan has kept mum on the split, and there wasn't much fanfare about it at the time, despite the fact that Meghan and Engelson had been together for nearly a decade by the time they called it quits. But when Meghan and Prince Harry's romance heated up and became public, Meghan's former best friend, Nanaki Pretty, who was also maid of honor at her wedding to Engelson, turned traitor in a scandalous December 2017. In the shocking takedown, Pretty alleged that Meghan unceremoniously and unfairly dumped Engelson as soon as she reached stardom with Suits. If that wasn't enough, just months before Pretty's betrayal, there was buzz that Engelson was developing a divorce comedy based on his breakup from Meghan about a man who now has to share custody of his children with the royal family now that his ex has married into it. That show has yet to be developed, however, if it does, we imagine that will be yet another difficult day for Meghan in connection with her ex. Meghan Markle's sisters tell all books. Samantha Grant wasn't done attempting to make her half-sister look bad with her tweets about not being invited to the royal wedding. By early 2019, Grant was planning on releasing two books about her life growing up with Meghan Markle, called In the Shadows of the Duchess. Though she never shared exactly what the books would be about, Grant did call them a memoir and hinted that it would go behind the scenes of their childhood. She said, "You've got to read my book to see what things were really like. I have a very big mouth and speak my mind, as the world can see, at any cost, even if it makes me unpopular. But I tell the truth even if it makes me unpopular. I've never been afraid of the truth, because if the truth makes me lose friends, then they weren't friends that I wanted to have anyway." At the time, it seemed that Grant's books would be published in 2019. As of this video, they still haven't been released, and it's not clear whether or not they're still happening.
Check out one of our newest videos right here, plus even more LMT videos about your favorite stuff. For coming soon, subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one. Stop.